Hello everybody, the topic that we shall discuss today is real income and nominal income. This is one of the widely discussed topics in insurance and in economics. So let's start. I will explain this point of view with the help of an example, then we shall discuss its definition. This is Mr. Zhu, and we suppose that in 2010 his monthly income was $100, and with this $100 he was able to buy 10 grams of gold. But with the passage of time, in 2020, his income grew up and it became $200. But the situation gone worse. With this $200, he was not able to buy this 10 grams of gold. Apparently, you can see, previously, he was receiving $100, but now he is receiving $200. But what is the reason he is unable to buy 10 grams of gold, which he was able to buy in 2010? Actually, the matter is that apparently we can say that his income has grown up. This is nominal income that we can see apparently. But this nominal income, this grown up nominal income, has reduced his purchasing power because price of gold has gone up. So, in spite of his grown up nominal income, his real income has gone down. Now, we have understood the concept of real income and nominal income. Now, we shall move to the definitions of nominal and real income. Nominal income is that income we can see, and the real income represents purchasing power of money. Actually, the matter is that whatever money can purchase is the real income. We see in our day-to-day life that government employees and other people who were able to manage their lives 5 years before or 10 years before, now with their grown income, they are unable to manage their lives. The actual matter is that their real income is going down with increasing prices of things.